So guys, here we are again with our second video on addressing types. This is Saket, Piyush and Mayank. So there are four levels of addresses used in an internet employing the TCP/IP protocols. First is the physical or link address, second is logical or IP address, third is port address, and fourth is specific address. So we'll see the first addressing type, which is physical address.
Physical address, also known as link address, is the address of node as defined by its LAN or WAN. It is included in the frame used by the data link layer. It is the lowest level address. The physical address have authority over the network. The size and format of this address vary depending on the network. For example, Ethernet uses a 6-byte physical address that is imprinted on the network interface card. However, has a 1-byte dynamic address that change each time the station come up. For example, a node with physical address 10 sends a frame to a node with physical address 87. The two nodes are connected by a link. At the data link layer, this frame contains physical address in the header. These are the only address needed. The rest of the header contains other information needed at this level. The trailer usually contains extra bits needed for error detection. As the figure shows, the computer with physical address 10 is the sender and the computer with physical address 87 is the receiver. The data link layer at the sender receiver receives data from an upper layer. It encapsulates the data in the frame, adding a header and trailer. The header, among other pieces of information, carries the receiver and send physical address. Note that in most data link protocol, the destination address 87 in this link addresses. Note that in most data link protocol, the destination address 87 in this case come before the source address. We have shown a bus topology for an isolated LAN. In a bus topology, the frame in propagate in both direction. The frame propagates to the left dies when it reaches the end of the cable. If the cable end is terminated appropriately, the frame propagate to the right is sent every station on the network. Each station with a physical address other than 87 drops the frame because the destination address in the frame does not match its own physical address. The intended destination computer, however, finds a match between the destination address in the frame and its own physical address. The frame is checked, the header and trailer are dropped, and the data part is decapsulated and delivered to the upper layer. Logical address. Logical address are necessary for universal communication that are independent of underlying physical network. Physical address are not adopted in an internetwork environment where different network can have different address format. A universal addressing system is needed in which each host can be identified uniquely, regardless of the underlying physical network. The logical address are designed for this purpose. A logical address in the internet is currently a 32-bit address that can uniquely define a host connected to the network. No two publicly addressed and visible host on the internet can have the same IP address.
Now we will move towards the example of the logical address. This figure shows a part of an internet with two routers connected, three LANs. Each device has a pair of addresses for each connection. In this case, each computer is connected to only one link and therefore has only one pair of addresses. However, Each router is connected to three networks, so each router has three pairs of addresses, one of each connection. Although it may obvious that each router must have a separate physical address for each connection, it may not be obvious why it needs a logical address for each connection. The sender encapsulates its data in a packet at the network layer and adds two logical addresses, A and P. Note that in most protocols, the logical source address comes before the logical destination address. The network layer, however, needs to find the physical address of the next hop before the packet can be delivered. The network layer consults its routing table and finds the logical address of the next hop to be F. The ARP discussed previously finds the physical address of router 1 that corresponds to the logical address of 20. Now, the network layer passes this address to the data link layer, which is then encapsulate the packet with physical destination address 20 and physical address 10. The frame is received by every device on LAN 1. But is discarded by all except router 1, which finds the destination physical address in the frame matches with its own physical address. The router decapsulates the packet from frame to frame to read the logical destination address P. Since the logical destination address does not match the router's logical address, the router knows that the packet needs to be forwarded. The router consults its routing table and ARP to find the physical destination of the next hop, that is router 2, creates a new frame, encapsulates the packet and sends it to router 2. Note that the physical address in the frame, the source physical address changes from 10 to 99. The source physical address has been changed from 10 to 99. The destination physical address changes from 20 to 33. The logical source and destination address must remain same, otherwise the packet will be lost. At router 2, we have similar scenario. The physical addresses are changed and a new frame is sent to the destination computer. When the frame reaches the destination, the packet is decapsulated. The destination logical address P matches the logical address of the computer, which is the physical address. Now, the data is encapsulated. The data is decapsulated from the packet and delivered to the upper layer. The physical addresses will change from hop to hop, but the logical addresses usually remain the same in logical address. So now we will go to the third type, which is the port address. The IP addresses and the physical addresses are necessary for a quantity of data to travel from a source to the destination host. However, arrival at the host is not the final objective of data communication on the network. Today, computers are devices that can run multiple processes at the time. The end objective of the internet communication is a process of communicating with another process. For example, PC A can communicate with PC C using telnet. At the same time, PC A is also communicating with PC B with the file transfer protocol. For these processes to receive data simultaneously, we should need a method to label the different processes. Or we can say that the need addresses in the TCP/IP architecture, the label assigned to a process is called a port address. And a port address in TCP/IP is 16 bits in length. Now we'll take an example where shows two computers communicating via internet. The sending computer is running three processes at the time with port address A, B and C. The receiving computer is running two processes at this time with port addresses J and K. Process A in sending the computer needs to communicate with process J in the receiving computer. Note that although both computers are using the same application FTP, for example, the port addresses are different because one is a client program and other is the server program. As well, we see to show the data from process A need to be delivered to process J and not K. The transport layer encapsulates data from the application layer in a packet and adds two port addresses A and J, that is source and destination. The packet from the transport layer is then encapsulated in another bank at the network layer with logical source and destination A and P. Finally, this packet is encapsulated in a frame with the physical source and destination addresses of the next hop. We have not shown the physical address because they change from hop to hop inside the cloud designated as the internet. Note that although physical addresses change from one hop to another, logical and port addresses remain the same from source to destination. There are some exceptions to this rule, but we will go with them also. So this was all about addresses. This is the question bank related to our topic. These are 10 questions which we can use for revision of this topic. Thank you.